I've been having the worst heartburn.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that.
Yeah, it's like pretty terrible.
Yeah. How long have you been having it?
Like at least a couple times a week for the past couple weeks.
Okay, how pregnant are you?
Very pregnant.
Okay, great. Well, let me tell you, this is actually really common with women and that are pregnant. And the reason is because as your baby grows, literally your baby's pushing on your stomach.
Oh, I feel that.
Yeah. So, and it's likely to push some of the stomach acid into your throat, into your esophagus, which is actually what is bothering you. It's that acid on skin that's not supposed to have acid on it. And also sometimes our hormones when we're pregnant kind of have us relax. And so that little layer between the throat and the stomach also can relax and let some of the acid through. So it's really common, but I'd love to talk about some ways to kind of relieve it. Have you tried anything to make it better yet?
I'm afraid to try anything because I'm mostly just afraid it's, like, really going to hurt my baby. Mm-hmm. And I, like, I'm trying to protect my baby.
Yeah, good. That's wonderful. Well, there are some just lifestyle things you can do, and it could be wise to try that first. So you can try and have smaller meals. So literally just not packing your stomach as full so that the contents don't go higher. So have 5 to 6 meals a day instead of 3 big ones. You could save your liquids for in-between meals rather than at meals. So instead of having a large glass of water or juice or whatever, you are just going to do that in between.
Okay.
Another thing is when we eat and then lie down immediately, sometimes that can cause the acid to come up. So staying upright, you know, an hour or so after meals.
Okay.
And then also some people find they have more heartburn with spicy, fatty, greasy food. So you can maybe try to avoid those if you can.
I love those so much.
I know. I understand. So you could try those. If you feel like those aren't working for you or you don't want to try those, there are some over-the-counter meds you can try.
Okay.
So what's important is that it's going to be antacids, okay? You want to avoid those with aspirin. Okay. So like Alka-Seltzer would not be a good choice.
Okay.
Okay. But Mylanta, Tums, those would be pretty good choices.
Okay.
Because you could try that.
Okay. And that's safe for the baby?
Yeah, and you know, that's a good thing to bring up, is those last two I mentioned are safe for the baby, Tums and Mylanta. Heartburn itself is not bad for the baby, but there are some things that can happen with heartburn that are, some things that can happen with heartburn that I do want to know about and that I can't just tell you are safe overall. So if you are waking up at night with heartburn, I want to know about that.
Okay.
Or if you are losing weight, spitting up blood, having black stools, then I want to hear about those things.
Okay.
Because those could be indicative of, like, something else going on.
Okay.
Anything else?
Try and cut back on the spicy foods, eat a little bit less at a time, save my liquid, stay upright, and if that doesn't work, try Tums.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other
Those are really treatments? The best things. There's not, I mean, if you're really having a lot of trouble with it, I want to be talking about, like I said, if you're losing weight or having trouble swallowing, things like that, could have progressed to something more serious, and I want to hear about it. We can talk about more other methods, but this is a good place to start.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you, Kimberly.
My pleasure.